Hello, Ranos here, and welcome to episode of Space Engineers. In this episode, we're going to be looking at this base right here, which is something new that I've developed due to the new oxygen settings that they've implemented into the game. Considering you're going to make sure you need a supply of oxygen pretty much instantly. Otherwise, you're going to die. It'll be a good thing. Well, anyway, how about we get started on this little review of this thing? So I've decided to change how I do my Space Engineers videos. Rather than building the ship from, well, the ship or station or whatever from scratch, I will just be showing you what I've created, especially considering the previous one took like 5 episodes to complete. It's a bit annoying, but never mind. Anyway. This base is fully powered by solar panels. It has 4 connectors in order to connect to ships. And you may have already noticed, it has mods. The tramps are vanilla parts, so ignore them. But these containers right here are the extra large containers from a mod pack. Well, from a mod. It has several containers. What is it? It only adds one, but modifies all the containers' storage limits. Anyway, I'll list that mod in the description below, but there are a couple more. Now, when I go up here, we've got the button pedestals at each of the doors. There's a door on each side. Now, these pedestals are very useful. It's a single button, so you're not wasting space. And not only that, it's cheaper on resources. Now, when you press this, did I press it? Yes, I did. It will activate the airlock system, which, that's what these timer blocks are for the whole airlock system. What I've done with this airlock system, ignore the alarm going off twice, it's not meant to go off, there's not meant to be a pause between it. I'll sort them out later, before I put the blueprint onto the workshop. Anyway. Once the entire station is being depressurized, I kind of depressurize the entire station just to make things simpler. Especially considering there's a lift in the middle. Anyway, these lights will continue to flash while it's depressurized, letting people know that there is no air on the inside. However, once you are inside, you can then press one of the 4 buttons that are on the inside. Press, it'll automatically close the door, turn them off so you can't open and close them, and refill the room. Let's just give it a moment. Once the room's pressurized, the lights will turn off. And now, it won't open. Yeah, ignore all that stuff. Anyhoodle. This screen will show you oxygen, that will show you the components. On the other side we've got ingots and ore. This was all due to a script that I've got. I didn't create it. Anyway, here are your 8 oxygen tanks. You have 4 arc furnaces, 4 refineries and 4 assemblers underneath, with the gravity generator. And there's 4 air vents in each floor. And as you can tell, the ceiling lights I've got here are from a decoration mod pack, which I will link down below. And also I put this here just to be convenient. Because on this floor, I don't think there is anything apart from the doors you can access. Oh, you can also go for the air vents. Yeah, it's rather slow. If it goes too fast, then it has a chance of killing players. I'm pretty sure someone's figured out the best speed, or the fastest speed that lifts like this can go at. Oh, and that's another thing. I completely forgot that this thing that I'm stood on is from a mod. Wow, there's quite a few mods I need to put in. Yeah, this is the catwalk elevator mod, which I'll show you more of it as soon as this menu's shown up. And there we go. These are the parts. You used to not being able to tell these 4 from the original catwalk pieces. But the modder has been quite kind as to add in little squares to signify that it's from this mod. And that's useful for the sides. It's got four buttons on it, so a bit too many for some cases. And here we are, at the top floor. Here's a container, so you can get to oxygen bottles. Oh, containers. No. Canisters. What do you want to call the darn things? That's the timer block to trigger that, which has the script, which was created by, I think it's, who was it by? M Master? Can't remember. Anyway, there'll be a link for it on the description below. That's an example word. Yeah, there's his link for the video he's done of it. Either way, this thing's very useful. I'm still going through the process of doing some modifications, as in adding mod items to this list. The only one he's currently got here is a supercharger, since it's from a popular mod. Yeah. And here's a med bay from another mod. I just... which is pretty helpful, considering how small it is, it easily fits in the space, for I can't place anything here because of that. And the reason why they're on the corners is because I can't place anything there because of these windows. And apart from all of that, we've got this right here. Once you've entered, you'll see an external view. And I've got pretty much all four panels covered. And we move to an angle where these tags aren't covering the thing up. Here, you can toggle each of the machinery on and off. This page is arc furnaces and refineries. Turn them on and off when they are needed. So when you have a large bunch of ore, like iron ore, or cobalt, or even nickel, it's best to make sure the arc furnaces are turned on first so they start refining it all first. On this page we have the assemblers and the oxygen generators. Oxygen generators are also helpful for filling up oxygen tanks, but you can do that straight from the small container on the top floor. This page is a combination of all of them. All the assemblers are in a group, with number one turning them all on, and number two turning them all off. The reason I've done it for turning them all on and off, rather than having a single button to toggle, because if you have one on, and then you hit the toggle button, you'll turn that one off and all the others on. So this just makes things a bit more convenient. So that's what this does for all the different things. On this page, as you can see, being the fullest of the lot, is the first two turn, or the first one turns all of the assemblers, refineries, arc furnaces, and oxygen generators all on, and the other one, and number two turns them all off. Number three turns the ceiling lights on and off. Number four activates the airlock system. So, you know, you can control it from up here. And when someone wants to come to the door, you just activate it to save a little bit of time, because it does take some time before they can actually get in. And if someone needs to get in urgently, because they're running out of oxygen, you know, do it like that. Number five is to start up the block that sorts out the LED stuff. LCD stuff, because when you load up the world, there is a chance that that timer block will stop. So all you gotta do is press number 5 and it'll start up again. The others are just switch locks, so if anything comes up to connect to the connectors, you press these buttons and it will turn it off, lock it and unlock it. Very useful for small ships, because I've made lots of small ships, but some of them couldn't escape the pull of a connector because it didn't have strong enough thrusters, so I always had to make it turn its own connector off, which is the simplest way to do it. But this just they're still going to do that, but this will allow the station to control who's connected and who isn't, although it might get a bit awkward. Unfortunately, there's no more tabs in order to turn these on and off, which is unfortunate, but oh well. And that's pretty much it. All the mods used will be in the description below. However, there is a way to get all the same effects without any mods. Apart from this, there's absolutely nothing we can do about this one. So yeah, you're gonna need it. And you're probably gonna need the mod for that as well, because I don't think there's a way to do anything about that. However, for the lights, you can swap them for the interior lights. And as for all the button panels, you can just swap them for the default button panels. And that's everything. There will be... Well, I will put this as a blueprint on the workshop as soon as I've fixed all the other little bits, because there's still one or two things I've got left to do. I just need to find them. The only other thing that I've done is, as soon as I get down, you get to a control panel. This one will do. Is that I've hidden most of the stuff. You know, just to make it a little cleaner. I don't think it hides the what's in the container. Well, the inventory section. Nah, doesn't. Oxygen generator's still showing up. Wait. So you can stick ice in there? Convenient. Storage place for your ice. That's handy. And yeah, everything still pops up here. Everything's still working in the assemblers. Don't ask why there are two fours. That's probably because of all the mirroring I did. And yeah, that's everything. Well, anyway, if you've enjoyed this video, please leave a like and even subscribe for more episodes. And I will see you all next time. Bye-bye.